In this video, I'm going to teach you how to use schematics in Minecraft CurseForge. It's a very easy process, so make sure to follow along. In this video, I'm going to showcase how easy it is to install schematics in any mod pack or standalone installation that you have in CurseForge. So you can go over to CurseForge, select Minecraft, and open any of your mod packs. You will notice that I don't have any actual mod packs here. I only have these two installations, but I'm still going to give you instructions on how to do this, and you will be able to follow along if you have a mod pack, like all the mods, for example. Just click on the specific mod pack that you would like to install schematics in. And then once you have it selected, click on this option here, Add Content. So right below the title and the option to play, you will see Add Content. And now you can look for Schematica. Now you will notice that when you look for Schematica, nothing appears. So what you have to do is look for Lightmatica. As you can see now, you will be able to find some options. The difficulty here is that it seems like Lightmatica is not being updated constantly. So if I remove the version, now it appears. So the latest release of Lightmatica was 1.21.1. If you have a mod pack that is running on this version, then the install option will be available. Otherwise, you will have to look into these alternatives here. So these are going to be updated versions of Lightmatica. So as you can see, they are updated for 1.21.4 and other future versions possibly. And they are made by the community. But if you want the official one, then you will need to be running version 1.21.1. So all that you have to do in that case is to click install. If you want to double check, you can click on the mod name, and as you can see, this is Lightmatica that allows you to use any schematics. Once you install it, there will be a new folder on your .minecraft installation, and in there you will be able to drop schematics. I'm going to create a new profile here on an older version just to demonstrate that it works. So I'm going to create this with fabric, and if I go over to add content and I'll look for Lightmatica, I'll be able to find it here. So I can click on install, and after it is done, you will notice that on this installation of Minecraft, you will get not only Lightmatica but also Malillib. This is going to be needed to make it work, so don't worry, this is going to be installed alongside Lightmatica and you shouldn't remove it. Make sure that both are active and you will be good to go to use Lightmatica. So I hope I was able to help you. If this video helped you, please consider subscribing. As you can see, 83% of the people watching our videos are not subscribed. By subscribing, you can help us make higher quality videos. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you on the next one.